This is an Off the Tongue podcast. Welcome to Skeet Mansfield.
What's up, Skeet Mansfield?
There he is.
I'm Tim Metcalf, here to bring you all of the awesomeness of the world of skateboarding without actually knowing how to skateboard.
Wagga wagga.
Luckily, the stars of the show, BJ Price and Adam McElroy, do you know how?
We sure do.
That was
leave everything in. I'm just saying, leave everything in.
That was not
episode.
As good as last.
Wild.
But
it's
no, well, first awesome. Of all, I like that you read that.
I did.
You had the script.
Well, see, it's better than what we do.
Yeah.
We at least have cliff notes now.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, I didn't expect that, and then I see you peeking, and I'm like, oh, he's got it.
Yeah,
got it.
Yeah,
I like it.
Well, last time I told him to like write.
I wrote it out.
Yeah.
I was like, please.
Well, what's
please,
up, everybody?
Hi.
I still feel like my mic is sounding weird, but that's okay.
Well, it's your mic. It's not mine.
I pulled out the Shure.
Yeah, that's
the
cool.
SM58.
Do you want to tell people what you just said? Into the microphone?
You can hear it. You can hear it. It's the SM58.
But see how quiet you are compared
yes,
to...
Yes, it's quieter because it's like if you're watching, you're like, well, what did he do? You look at the screen and you're like, oh, he held it away from him.
You know,
and now he's back.
Nobody can hear you, you know?
Yeah,
like,
this
what
is
do
terrible.
Do
yes, you
no,
can.
You
no,
you can hear you. The mic cannot hear
yes,
you.
Yes,
you're not registering on here. Like,
yes, I am.
No, you're not.
You're registering in here. You're not registering in the audio.
You see what I have to put up with?
I'm sorry
ridiculous.
We have to...
What do you mean?
Hey, you guys.
All right, well, what's up, guys?
They can't hear you.
SM58.
This is the worst start of any episode we've ever done.
Wrong!
And
wrong, we have had worse.
That's fair. I'm
much
yeah,
worse.
That's fair. But let's get into stuff, because people
are
been here, and like...
Forget where I am, guys.
We need to stop just bantering for 100 minutes and not talk about anything. We got to talk about stuff.
It'd be like, well, this is an Escape Mansfield episode. They're not
let's
just
keep blowing
talking
raspberries
about
into the microphone.
Someone do. There's not a cat
it's
down
not
here
like,
laying down
it's
your
not
foot.
Like you've been
everything's
podcasting
weird.
4 years.
Man, that's a
like,
while.
There's some basics that you should understand.
I got so much Spose stuck in my head. Hey, Tim, can you hit the news one? Whatever that button is. It's on the... There you go, buddy. Hey, yo, buddy. Turn it up. That one. We're going to hit it again. Everybody
nailed it,
down.
Nailed it.
He nailed it. Let's do this first try.
From around the world, it's the skate news you need to know.
This is pure dysfunction.
Welcome. This is not.
It's
this is not. This is what the people
this
come
is
here
7
for.
Minutes of dysfunction. Nah. I would like... I'm
see, Josh enjoys the banter.
Banter.
Josh, don't do this. Don't
Tim's,
do this.
I still don't think Tim's hitting enough buttons. I want more buttons in this
okay.
podcast.
Okay.
I don't know, guys.
More buttons.
Banter, this is
banter,
bad.
Banter.
Oh, you know what? My guy. See? You got to turn it up so everybody can hear the buttons.
I'm afraid that... Because when we play music, it gets louder. And, yeah.
Well,
I had to turn it down for that.
Yeah, you can turn it down for that, but then... Why is it so quiet? Why could you not talk while I was doing that?
Allegedly.
Because we're apparently breaking all podcasting rules today.
Why are,
that one
no
didn't make
podcasting.
Sense. I had to try it. I said,
I just want to talk about stuff because we've literally talked about nothing for six
banter.
Minutes.
Banter.
And people are just going to be like, okay, get to the stuff that I care
okay.
about. Like,
okay.
From around the world, it's the news you need to know.
God.
I'm just trying to keep you on track, you know?
Right.
Got to play it again.
What were we doing?
Got to do it again.
What are we doing? Hey, you know what the thing is? Is I don't have the, like, local, the... What was the one that I used to have? What was it? My girl called...
That was pretty good.
Is it where
my girl calls
park?
Our love life
park?
7 minutes of dysfunction.
That's hilarious. Way to go, Brandon. I forgot. I need that button for this.
It's still skate news.
I mean, it is news. I mean,
if we ever get to it.
I was waiting for you to do it. Cause
you're the one with the surprise.
I drug you along so that you could, like, make it happen, you know, so you could do this whole section all by yourself. I believe in you.
Please tell the people what they want to hear.
We went to the Lexington City Council.
Yeah.
And we said, give us a skate park. No, so I took Adam for the first time to the Lexington City Council. He had never been.
They're usually on Tuesdays.
Yeah,
and I
where
can't make
he cannot make it back in time because they're like right at the time that he could never make.
Yeah.
So I took him and I'm like, hey, let's go see the whole thing. So because we were after City Council, building and grounds was after City Council.
We were only there for 4 hours.
Yeah, it was a long time. My wife was worried.
Yeah.
She had
Did you get arrested? Did you say something dumb? And get arrested. That's probably what she thought.
Because the police station's like right there.
Yeah, we're in the police station.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Good. It's a good thing you text me because we're in trouble. No. So I basically, we went there early to kind of see kind of how the flow of everything worked.
By the way.
And
yes. And I just want to say this because this happened right when we got there. I love BJ to death. And this is just something that I just love, and I told like three people right. because I think it's hilarious. So we get there, and we are early. We knew we were early, but like he said, we wanted to get there to kind of see the whole thing and kind of show that we're serious, right? We'll sit through this whole boring thing. It doesn't matter. Like
I find it fascinating.
It was kind of cool, not going to lie. But
Rose, we'll back.
But we get in there, and literally before we even sit down, the mayor's right there. And he's like, hey, he's like, I think you guys are a little early, right? And BJ was like, well, you know, we want to be here a little early, like blah, blah, blah. And then do you remember what you said to the mayor?
I don't know.
You said, we're Jay chilling.
Yeah.
He said, it's cool, we're Jay chilling. And I'm like, no, dude, that's the mayor.
It's Bobby Jarve, dude.
Like,
Bobby Jarvis.
Just immediately, like, we hadn't even sat down yet. We were in the process of sitting down. And BJ sits down and goes, we're Jay chilling. And kicks back like this. And I'm like, bro, don't Jay chill the mayor. Like,
I did.
I know.
And I'll
and
do
I was
it
like,
again.
No. Like, it was fine.
Bro,
like,
I know these people now. Yeah. I told you. Like,
but
everybody is up there. I'm like,
right?
There's Brenda. She's the best.
Brenda's
there.
Cool.
Yeah, dude.
Seemed very cool to be
honest.
Yeah,
they were. It was a lot of fun. A whole lot of white people.
But yeah, I was like, you just killed the mayor within 30 seconds of talking to him. I was like, geez, BJ.
What?
You just can't turn it off, can you?
No. I am me.
You can't not Jay chill.
Right.
Yeah, dude, I'm out here.
So I wanted to say that because that happened literally the second we walked through the door.
So we had to sit through everything, but it was cool. I was kind of trying to tell him how, like, the whole city council stuff runs. And I'm like, oh, when city council, because Brenda came out, and she's like, you guys staying for city council? I said, yep, we're here to chill for that, too. And
she's so sweet.
She was the best. She gave us candy. It was awesome. Just walking around with a basket, just giving people candy. It's like, yeah, that's awesome. But yeah, so you like have to, if you go to a city council meeting, I implore everybody should go to
city council
in the town that you live in at some point, just so you can see kind of how it works and how stuff happens. Because we can talk about now as well, like where the budget goes as well.
And I actually wanted to speak to that just for a second.
I still got that paper upstairs.
Just because we were playing in Harper's birthday party.
Yeah.
And Jess was like, let's do it at Bicentennial.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't know if we want to do it at Bicentennial just because of, like, the concerns they had. And I was like, but we know from this meeting they're redoing Bicentennial this year. So I was like, it'd be cool if they did it before her birthday, then that'd be great.
Yeah, you know what?
But, like, some of the concerns that came up there, I was like, I don't know if we want to go playing on Bicentennial. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, so that actually affected my real life today, like, just being there.
Dude, what about the guy behind us who's like, hey, can I speak at this? And Bobby Jarvis just like, we're talking up
here. Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Oh, God.
That was hilarious.
He was like, no!
100%.
Well, it seemed like there was two sections. There was one, like, for the people, blah, blah, blah. And then the other one was just for, like, them to discuss.
Yeah.
So, like...
Like, it's a public forum type thing. Well, it's not a public forum. It's all open to the public, but it is not necessarily...
Some of it's, like, public interaction, not all of it.
Correct.
Though.
But you have to be, like, you get your time, and you get, like, 3 minutes to talk or whatever.
Yeah.
So we got to, Donald Zahner was there. He's running for sheriff, so we had... He just got up and spoke for a little bit. He's like, here's
fine.
My plan.
Yeah.
I think he's dope. He's got my vote. Shout outs. Donald Zahner. Voting for him.
Me too.
Sheriff. Dude, this guy over here, every time they're like, make sure you get out there and vote, I'm just like,
He like pestered me about something in the middle of the meeting, and it was something about voting and stuff.
Yeah.
And I'm so clueless, I didn't know what he was talking about. I'm like, what are you talking about? And
vote, he's like, you're like, vote for what?
He's like, you need to register to vote. And I was like, ah, I don't know.
Because they even set up.
That's my response.
Wait, what was Keith's last name?
Couldn't tell.
Sweat.
Oh, I can't remember. Keith.
Keith.
The guy who runs buildings and grounds, that dude's solid dude. He was probably my favorite dude.
Oh,
dude was just cutting it up there. But also
Mason?
Bringing. No.
Keith.
No, it. Oh, it was a B. It started with a B.
Basin.
Yeah, Basin. That's it.
Huh.
He was very cool. He was really cool.
He had
a paper with like, these are the things people have told me that we need to talk about. And
right.
Was very forth, but he was just a silly dude.
I loved it, and before I even really knew who he was, I was just like, I like that guy. Like
he kept making jokes and stuff, like picking up the gavel, looking at the mayor, like he's gonna start. He's like, I'm gonna start,
right?
it was,
and this is a guy in his probably mid 60s, 50s, but he's a silly goose, and I loved it.
It was funny.
I loved it.
So it made me feel comfortable,
to be honest.
Yeah, but you go through that whole thing, but after that is the buildings and grounds, where we were specifically there to talk to the buildings and grounds people, and afterwards they went through everything that they're going to do with, like, apparently they get from one of the...
It's a grant.
Some stuff comes from the grant, but the actual...
Or, like,
the
portion
levy.
Of the levy.
The levy.
Yeah.
Yeah, the levy that was voted upon for the parks. They have like $90,000, and they went through. They're like, "Here are the needs. What can we do?" So they
it was about $150,000 worth of needs.
So you always go above.
Yeah.
So you know
but
what
as,
to cut.
As the guy's saying this, and they are valid needs, you know,
100%
and stuff like that. And he's listing these off. He gave us everybody printouts with like numbers and stuff.
Yep.
And BJ just goes, "We're screwed." He's like, "Yeah, we're not getting nothing."
Because they're like voting on it all. They're like, "Okay, we could keep all of this and stuff." And I'm like, "That means we're getting
that's
zero.
The whole budget." They literally voted for the whole budget in front of us, and then wiped it all out and said, "What do you got?"
And we're so like, you're what? Here.
And
I'm like,
"Hey!"
I was like a little discouraged at that point, but I still like went into my whole spiel because I never talked to Mr. Basin about. All this stuff. So
right.
I told him, like, here's who we are. Here's what we're doing. Here's what I want to do. Here's what I need from you. And so it was basically, I'm like, I need the, you know what kind of advertising we can do for this. And shout out to Eric as well for showing up.
He helped
for sure. Because he's been helping me out a ton. He's on the park board and stuff. And he was able to verbalize some of the stuff that I, you know, in their speak, basically.
And not Jay Chillen speak.
Yeah. Because there was a point where they could tell I was serious because they're like, well, you know, it might not be this year. And, you know, this, that, and the other. And I looked at him, I'm like, it's happening this year.
Right.
Because I'm doing after school programming next year. So this is happening.
Yeah.
And they just all kind of looked at me and I was like, oh, I got serious.
I did
there
look
for a
up
second.
Insurance, by the way.
Oh, good. Because, well, Reinhardt is the one in town that could.
I just did a rough search. Generally speaking, about 50, 60 a month. That's it.
That's way better than I was anticipating.
But that's what
I think they're requiring like a million coverage.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. But I just looked up nonprofit general.
I don't know if they're
going to
check that. We can just tell them.
Yeah.
We can just tell them.
I looked up general liability for nonprofits, and it said anywhere from 50 to like $70.
Well, that's good. And I know Reinhardt and Walter, or whatever it is, it's right there on Park Avenue.
Yeah.
They do.
And they even said there was the people behind us was like, it's not as expensive as you think. So,
yeah.
I'm confident
we only need
it
for certain things, too.
Yeah. But I think you have to pay for the, well, I don't know, because it's different insurance companies and all that, but whatever, we'll get into that.
We're learning about all that either way. It's we got to speak to them, and I'd asked Brenda to send it to me. She never did today. I was trying to get her to send me, because they didn't even know how to word the motion, because somebody had, so the way it works is somebody makes a motion, and they say, I move to blah, 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 this, and then somebody has to second it. And then once it gets second, it has to go to vote.
Then it can
so
be
then they then each person will vote. There'll be yays and nays, and you know, two thirds wins. But
it was interesting too, and we don't have to get on this point for long. But there was a point prior to us where they were voting on something, and one guy did say no about something.
Good old Kim.
So then they kind of discussed it and came to an agreement. But before that, everything was like yes, 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 and then it was yes, yes, no, yes, yes, and then it was kind of cool to see how they kind of. It's like okay, well, pause. Like let's figure this out.
Yeah,
and they ended up figuring it out. So it was kind of cool, but
yeah. So it's. It was a victory, basically.
Yeah.
So they made the motion for us. We get the property to be able to, you know, fix.
To repair
and make proper skate park.
Yep.
And we have the okay to go fundraise.
So it's
now we can raise money for this and make this happen.
It's similar to Liberty, but not quite the same. From what it sounds like, it's the way I've been describing it to people is we're basically able to manage the park and fix it and repair it in whatever ways we, not in whatever ways we see fit, but we kind of present it to them and more or less we can kind of do it-ish kind of thing.
Right. And
But everything is still Lexington's property. Obviously, it's not Skate Ohio Skate Park, but they're giving us some type of contract or grant or land grant or whatever they wanted to call it to where we have permission to make the modifications that we want to make. So,
and the thing that I surprised Adam with earlier today was I have a friend who can do renderings and stuff, and I just let him know. I'm like, hey, this is what's happening. I really could use a rendering of what the skate park's going to be. So that when I go to ask for donations, I have something to show. It's like, this is what we're trying to do. And, so...
Asterisk subject to change.
Yeah. So we're kind of working on that. And, like, because I had to... He's trying to figure out, it's like, okay, what's the layout going to look like so I can make it look like this, make sure this and all that. So I got him all the information he needs, and now he's going to get me a rendering so that I can, you know... get a big poster board and go in and be like, see, this is what's going to look like. You see over here? This is nice, too.
And it's pretty interesting because the city councilman brought up doing events there.
Yeah.
Brought up a stage.
Yeah, so we have about 8,000 square feet that we're not using inside that fence. And the idea is to put a stage kind of on the transition line of the skate park and this other spot and maybe make the stage somewhat skatable. And have bleachers. Apparently, there's a big company in Lexington that specifically makes aluminum bleachers. Who knew?
Yeah,
but we can go talk to them. And the one thing that kept driving me nuts is like people on the board, like, oh, did you know you could go see if this company would make you a ramp? And I'm like, I don't want anybody's ramps. Just
right.
We're doing the concrete. So our goal right now, if anybody out there's got this kind of cash laying around, we need $100,000.
Easy,
right? That's all we need, and then we get a skate park back. It's going to be awesome. And also, they're on board with every year putting money in the park budget for us to get another obstacle. Like, put like, I don't know, $20,000 in the budget to be like, here's your $20,000. You know, what are you going to buy with it? So we could order some more obstacles.
And to be fair, I mean, obviously $100,000 is a lot of money, but given... two things, given the luck that we've had lately and just really the support, you know, around town and the expo stuff, the commerce stuff. Like,
I'm confident we'll have this.
I was going to say, I don't want to promise anything, but I'm very confident that we'll get this done this summer.
4 months max.
I was going to say...
Four months max, we will have this.
Yeah, I was going to say by June.
But the other thing that they were saying is like if we went to CNG and they're like, yeah, we'll give you the money, they were okay with it being the CNG Lexington Park or whatever.
That's pretty cool.
And
yeah,
I did,
so that's something to sell a company on.
I actually
we can go to J&B Acoustical. We can go to Cardinal Rental. We can go to all these places that are in Lexington and be like, you're gonna get a big boost in advertising if you can help us reach this goal.
Well, yeah, but that sign. It's going to be, that's going to have to be for the biggest donor, You know, like we can't.
It'll be the park if somebody donates what we need.
Right, right, right.
Other than that, they're allowing us to do things like, you know, how they've have like brick walkways with like people can buy a brick.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, this is part of our donors. That's great. And that might be what we need to do. But I'm confident that there might be a company that's like, look, we'll give you half.
Right.
And maybe another company will be like, yeah, I'll give you 50 grand. Oh, yeah. Because right now, to do just the concrete and get everything out of there, we need $73,000.
Right.
That's the lowest I got. We had a couple companies. We had to get multiple bids for to bring to when you go to like city council in a village or a city, they normally want multiple quotes.
Yeah.
So we ended up getting a few quotes. Shout out Adam Mortz, by the way. I don't think we got to shout him out on here.
Oh,
dude's
back.
Fellow skateboarder. Dude owns a concrete company and is a skateboarder.
Yeah, that's clutch.
And boy, is he fun to talk to. He was a hoot, man.
Yeah.
That was just such a pleasant conversation.
By the way, you remember how like we were talking about how you just move quickly and don't tell me anything for a minute?
Yeah.
When you originally said, because this is how it went down, right? BJ was like, all right, we're going to try to work with Adam to see what we can get quoted, blah, blah, blah. And originally, the quote for everything, concrete, removal, all that kind of stuff, was 152, right? That's obviously very large.
Yeah, 152.
Now, he talked to Adam Mortz, got this figured out. We're all excited. A couple days go by, and this is where my confusion was, because I texted you back and I said, hey, did we ever get a... I was like, I'm assuming we haven't, just because you never freaking told me, but... Did we ever get a quote from them? And you said, yeah, and you said 111,000. So to me, I'm like, that's concrete. That's 111.
No.
Right, but you didn't
Adam
explain
doesn't
that.
Quote the job. He has the concrete.
Well, right, but then in our meeting with Lexington, you reveal, because later he's like, no, it's 35,000 for the concrete or whatever.
Something like that.
And then I was like, okay, that's cool. And then in the meeting, you reveal it's actually 15 and 19. And I'm like, oh, so there's
that's
more.
That's square foot.
No, it's 15 concrete, 19 to remove, is what you said.
Something like that.
But that's you didn't tell me any of this. You said 111, and I was like, oh.
Originally, it was. That was another company,
right.
And then my boy Sam came in clutch, and he's just like,
right.
He's like, look, we could. He's like, I know Adam real well. I'll work with him.
Right.
I'll get you a quote because he works with a couple local companies, and based out of Lexington, that'll help.
But my point is, you give me half information.
Yeah, kind
and of then
that.
Are confused why I don't
so
know.
So fast.
I know.
I got that quote that day.
I know. And I said, what's the quote? And you said 111 when I'm asking for the 35. Like,
well, no. Oh, that's
too many quotes. Yeah.
I sent you what Adam gave me.
Afterwards.
What?
Because I was like, that's a lot. I figured it'd be less than that.
No. Hit the fourth. No.
No, 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 no.
No. No.
One of us is right here, and
no,
not you.
It is me. So yeah, 73,000 is like the remove that like removes the pavement, all of it for the whole slab, which is like 147 by 132. We're replacing a slab that's 95 by 120,
right.
And then basically the ramps go back on it. We repair them as best we can. All that. I'd love to paint them. My goal, I don't know. It kind of depends on if we do. If like CNG comes in and just like drops a ton of money, I'm pretty sure the ramps will stay blue. but my goal is to paint the fence, have like purple and gold stripes, baby. Make it Lex. Make it pop.
Right.
Pow, looking good. And then paint the ramps, purple and gold, dude. Any of the rails, purple and gold. Let's make it Lex, dude. It's gonna be the Lex Park.
But
we get to add a couple things too. I've got reason why we're asking for 100,000 is because there's a couple obstacles we're gonna add, and there's a couple obstacles that we can build on there. And they're
make
okay
the
with
Lex,
all this.
The Lex Gen Park,
the Lex.
Oh, dude, Tim coming in clutch. Shout outs, Tim.
But yeah, so
shout
you know,
yourself out, dude.
We're just excited because it's pretty much go. Did we ever get
it's
the contract,
been,
or are we still?
No, I'm working.
That?
I'm working with him on that. I did talk to Pete today.
We're
but
still
listen,
waiting for the paperwork.
It's been over a year of me going to these super long, you know, meetings that they met at the park, or they like changed last minute, and I had to run to get there and keep updating. I'd show up, and they're like, "Well, you need to do this," and I'd go do it.
Right.
They're like, well, you need a nonprofit. I go to Caleb. Caleb, I'm dumb. And he's like, here's your nonprofit, dummy. And I'm like, sweet. Thank you, bro. and we just, I just, you know, just kept chugging along, dude. I wouldn't stop. And that was like the number one thing they would say to the city councilors. Like, he hasn't stopped. He keeps coming back.
He won't get out of my face.
Yes.
And he's been like, sleeping outside for the past 3 days.
Like, this is
get him off my curb.
And it came down to me basically just in their face, like, this is happening.
Yeah.
I'm like, I am manifesting.
Well, that was kind of the
it's on my
the,
vision board.
The strange part for me too, because we were talking about it and they're like, well, I don't know, budget, blah, blah, blah. And you're like, well, we have to because I have this thing that I want to do and I don't care what you say. And then they were like, well, I don't know. And then I don't know. And then there's a weird motion that is four sentences long. And like, and then everybody said yes. And BJ stood up and said, thank you. And I was like, wait, did we get it? Is like, that, what? Wait, did that just happen? Because like,
because the main guy's like, well, I guess I make a motion to allow
right.
repairs
right.
to the property that is at Plymouth.
It's not, hey, well, I shouldn't say that.
It's like every word is a guess.
I don't know. He was just saying
I'll say it because it doesn't
Plymouth
matter.
Street.
Don't pull up on my parents. My parents' address is so that's very
weird.
Odd. No. No, on that
anyway,
same road, it's right there.
That's funny. But yeah, he's just like stammering through.
If I broadcast that or not. But
yeah, I was like, don't pull up.
The best is he's just.
Josh knows. You don't want to pull up on my parents. You will get messed up. Not that he's ever done it. He just knows my parents.
Dude,
but
my favorite part was is just like he stammered through this whole thing that like took yeah. him forever. And I'm just sitting there. I'm like, I couldn't have said it better
right.
than myself.
And then a couple minutes later, Keith was like, and fundraising? And he's like, oh, yeah, and fundraising. Yeah, Josh says hard no. Yeah. They're so, great people, but don't spook them. Don't spook them.
Oh, dude. So the surprise I wanted to throw out at you today.
Oh, I figured it was the rendering.
No. Okay. No. The rendering's happening.
Oh, I thought it was the quote.
Oh, no.
That
everything's a surprise.
That
sorry.
Come in chunks.
So this like just happened. So I have to replace a sump pump underneath an elevator today. I guess it had died. Well, the float had died, and I'm like, I go under there and there's like 6 inches of water and stuff. So I'm like, whatever. I'm going home. I ran to Home Depot. I had to go get my boots, and I ran to Home Depot. I get the sump and all the parts I need, and I'm walking to the front, and I pass these big outdoor furniture boxes, right? Those things that we talked about, like right. we have the sled shed at Liberty.
Right.
And we talked about these boxes. It's like, oh, it'd be cool to put a sign on there and have like soccer balls and basketballs
right.
and footballs and all that stuff in there. Same deal. Use it, play with it, have fun, put it back when you're done. And so the next person can use it, right? So I'm up front, I'm checking out, and I'm just like, whatever. So I asked the guy, I'm like, hey, man, I've got a nonprofit. Here's something we did. Here's something I really want to do. And I need those. But do you guys do anything with nonprofits? Can you give this guy? He's like, yeah, hold on. So he gets on the phone, calls his manager. And he's like, yeah, they got a guy up here asking about nonprofit stuff and everything. And he's just like, yep. And he's like, he'll be right up. I'm like, oh, cool.
So I will say, when you throw the word nonprofit around, people start moving.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool.
Which I just assumed they would just be like, nah,
yeah.
you're cool or anything. So manager comes up.
Well, people are very
super,
helpful.
Super cool dude. And I just explain it. I show him just a picture of the sled shed. I said, here's what we did. It's really cool. Here's what's happened. And we kind of want to do the same thing in the spring. And what we need is a couple, you know, like this box
yeah.
that we can do this stuff with. And we walk over there and he's like, cool, you can have those too. And I'm like, oh man, dude, I can do a gift in kind and do all this stuff. He's like, nope. I'm like, well, do you want me to put your name on? He's like, nope. I'm like, he's like, it's fine. He's like, I'm happy. It's a good thing. You're doing a good thing. I want to help you. So you get these two boxes.
Wow.
So we got two of those outdoor boxes.
There we go.
For free.
That's
so that
really
we
cool.
can go do this. People just believe in it.
Yeah.
So I wish I had more time today because I was going to run to Dunham's and be like,
I was
going to
say, you should do that like next week.
Yeah, I was like going to go and be like, hey, you know, this is what we're doing. I got these boxes from Home Depot. I can shout you out if you want on this.
Because I
showed him. I'm like, hey, I worked at, you know, I work at Ace as well, and I put their name on the sign because they gave us sleds and stuff. He's like, nah, there you go. Right. We're happy to. Oh, and that's the other thing. He's like, hey, when if you're gonna do more of those sled shed things, come back to me. I'll give you lumber.
Man, wow, that's cool.
Like, what is happening?
I don't know. He's like, if you need wood for rams too, call me. I'll hook you up. And I'm like,
What? What is happening? Like, it's so awesome. Like, I do just want to say, and we've you know, repeated this multiple times and as much as we can, but like, I can speak for BJ and Tim and everybody in this. Like, we're just so thankful.
So thankful
for everybody, like, being so supportive, like. You know, we've talked about it, and I was like, when I was growing up, there was
nothing.
There was four skaters like that I knew, you know.
Yeah.
And now our group is almost to 1,200 people on Facebook, man. And like, you know, like,
and maybe not all of them are skaters, but a lot of
them.
But
they
aren't.
All support in some way. Like, you know, they at least follow the group. That's support enough. But yeah, it's just crazy, like how much people are supporting this, like. Like, without us really even having to explain much. It's like, hey, we're doing this and this, and they're like, I'm it. It's like,
okay.
Okay, yeah. Sweet. Like,
oh, man, we got them. They didn't read the fine print, you know?
Right.
I don't know. It's yeah, we've been very blessed with all of the stuff that's going on, and we're continuing to do good things, and we want to continue doing that.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's the update. All that stuff's going on. Yeah, I've got those boxes. They're in my truck because he's just like, yeah, I already... Because I went up to the front, and I'm like, hey, I was just talking to him. And he's like, nah, I already took care of it. Go ahead and take him.
Well,
so it's pretty good. I mean,
it's
all pretty good.
Tim, I don't know if you want to make a note of this or whatever. Remind me to talk about this after the show, the box thing that we're talking about. Just because there's some details that I don't necessarily want to, like, out people on. But
got it.
Just want to mention something. But try not to forget, Tim, because I will.
I got you.
Thank you.
So why don't
we? That's cool.
You know what? Well, before we talk about a ton of other stuff, let's talk about Patreon. A little bit about the Patreon.
Patreon.
Tim, why don't you shout outs all our Patreons.
Patrons.
Can you swap the thing so you can bring it up so everybody can see our patrons?
Oh.
I believe in you.
Well, you hit two buttons and nothing happened
yep,
so far.
He's doing great. Page up. Page down. There you go.
Love you, Tim.
I think
I
it's the page down. There you go. Now you just got to swap the screens.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? You see me? You feel me?
All right.
Oh, look at that.
It's
everybody
there.
Can see it.
Nice.
Hey.
Yeah, we want to shout out some people here.
Whoop.
And we're going to do just that. Liberty 120.
Mama. That's my mama.
Oh, okay. Oh, All right.
Cheryl Price.
Thank
AKA
you.
Mama.
Thank you, Mama Price. Leah Corto, Nate Collins. Nerd Overload Podcast.
Yep.
Shouts.
Thank you.
Mike Kovacic and
thank
Evil
you, shout.
Tony Means.
Tony, thank you.
Is there more?
Shout
down maybe? Or is that
go? That should be all the current ones. We went with active. So
yep.
Those are active ones. And the big shout outs to Nathan Collins,
yeah,
our big business
my
sponsor.
Guy, our business sponsor, the guy at Spitzer Motors. Everybody needs to go buy a car from him right
Max.
Now. Right
Max.
Now.
Do it.
Hit the button.
Do it.
We see a lot of us.
Do it.
There's like multiple of us.
Oh.
Do it.
Hit a button.
Inception.
My guy. Boom. It's
nailed it.
Nate Collins, the bestest dude ever. Saw him at Chipotle today.
Chipotle.
Why is he there? Because he's selling cars. Cars
selling
and he's
cars
got
and
bars.
Eating burritos,
spitting bars,
selling
out
cars.
There.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't either. But
yeah, hit up Nate. Nate's the man
for sure.
Skate Ohio discount on a car.
Oh, you could get one if you go over
there,
to.
There was,
I mean, if you go,
he was offering some certain things around the holidays. So I don't know what he can offer.
I don't want to speak for him.
Yeah, if you mention us,
you can hit him up 419-961-4581. Is that right?
Go.
Is that right?
That's
right.
I was trying to remember
right.
it. And I was like, I don't want to put it out there.
I know my wife's number. I know my number, and I know my mommy's number.
I know my number, and
my
I know my mom's number,
my
but
mom.
Only
my
because my
best
mom's
the best mommy.
My mom's number is the number that I use for all the discounts at Kroger.
Nice
and
way.
I also
else.
Use
get
my
her
mom's
them
number.
Points.
Yep.
I also use your mom's number.
Shout out Nate Collins.
Hey.
If you want to support us on Patreon, you can. You can go over to patreon.com/almost said teach a dummy. Skate Mansfield.
Yep.
And we've got all sorts of tiers there. There's ones that get you other things. You can get past episodes of Teach a Dummy. You can get special episodes of the behind the scenes of me completely redoing the basement here. I've got the breakdown of like all the stuff. There's one where I was semi-drunk and furious because like once I finally got all the tiles down, I still go back and look at this video occasionally. It just starts out with my face like twitching. There's just like wires hanging because like one of the lights that they had in here, like it was held up by a piece of wire.
Oh yeah, I
like,
remember that.
Showed me that. I was going bonkers. So many wires. Anyway, so you get stuff like that. We're gonna try to do more of that. I think there'll be more streaming and stuff from over there. We're finally to a point that I'm almost done with this. All I gotta do is finish the doors down here. And then I'll be able to start doing more streaming and stuff like
that.
Is it
10% and then 20, or is it 20 then
10? It's 10% right now.
So 10% of everything on the Patreon goes back to Skate Ohio.
Correct.
The nonprofit, because technically Skate Mansfield, Skate Ohio are two different things, two different organizations, or however you want to put
entities.
It. But
yeah.
Entities, there you go.
Thank you.
But yeah, 10% right now of everything goes to Skate Ohio. Once we hit $200 on the Patreon, anything from that point forward, 20% of everything goes to the nonprofit every month. So.
The two big things that kind of changed on the Patreon as well is like for the $50 tier, you get basically I've got GoPro and Adam does the editing skill stuff. Basically, we'll come film a video part for you. We'll hit you up we'll meet you at a skate park. We'll do all the filming for you. And get you a video part, and then it gets played on here. It goes on our YouTube channel, and it gets shared everywhere that we have. And like we said, we have almost 1,200 people in the group and everything, so it'll get shared to a lot of people.
And I do like to point out, too, when it comes to this, because I know people will automatically think, like, sketchy stuff, but the whole video goes to you.
Oh, yeah, we don't
own it.
We're
going to post it on our channel for your exposure, but you can obviously post it wherever you want as well. Yep. It's not like we're keeping it. It's not like, you know, it's all yours.
It becomes your video. We give it to you. You get the full rights to it.
Yeah.
Do whatever you want with it, but that's for you. That's a $50 tier. We have a $100 tier where you get to take over the studio and do your own podcast.
With or without us.
Yeah, we don't have to be a part of it, but we can set it up in a way that, because obviously back here, we can redo a lot of stuff so that you can like do your own episode of the podcast. It goes out on our feed. It goes out on the largest podcast network in the state of Ohio. Shout outs, Off the Tongue Podcast Network. Tim, tell the people who else on there now.
Bro, they just added another one.
I know. That's the Pints with Pals.
Pint Pals.
Tim's going to look it up while I just finish this out. So, yeah, $100. Again, that's your episode. You own it. Go put it wherever you want, but we'll put you out on the largest network. Who knows? You might end up loving it and being like, man, I'm good at this. And you can start your own podcast.
Yeah.
And we'll,
I'm selling
we'll
my old
that.
Podcast equipment, by the way, so if anybody wants some.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. Cause there's
I might
no reason,
buy something from you.
There's no reason to have it. You know,
I guess not.
I got the Rodecaster, and it's cool to have, but it's like, and
I got you.
And then
I might buy that off of you so I can have like one for the road.
What?
See what and I did there? Shout
there
out
a
to me.
Boo? Is there
I
a
was
boo
ask,
on here?
There, well, there's a no. I don't know. You play.
Too.
There's so many buttons. You can hit so many buttons.
Is
Where
that,
are you?
Is that my mic or is that your mic?
The one you're holding is yours.
Okay.
That one's mine.
Okay. So, but I do have at least one or two more handheld mics. But I have the pod mics, too.
Oh, no. So, oh, I have pod mics, too.
I was going to say.
They're in there. I never use them.
We can. Okay. I was going to sell them then. But
sell them.
Okay.
Shout
they're
out
not bad.
Off the Tongue Podcast Network.
Woo.
It's funny. That makes it okay. Pint
like,
Pals.
Yeah, that's good. I listen to that.
Greener Grass Podcast.
Great.
Skate Mansfield.
That's us.
And the Original Copycats Podcast.
Yeah. I think Average AF and Teach a Dummy is still on there.
Technically, they're still on
there.
They're
on there. But again, we might have. I had somebody reach out to me and say, I want to be on an episode of Teach a Dummy. And I'm like,
no,
we can still make that happen.
Yeah.
Just going to be in this studio.
Yep.
It's fun.
Interesting.
Oh, that's changing. We're just staying with it. Anyway, what were we doing?
Patreon.
Oh, yes, we did that. Shout outs, Patreon. Shout outs, all those people. Shout outs, Off the Tongue Podcast Network. And what should we do next? Ooh, I kind of want to do like non skate thoughts. Tim, hit that. Hit that one.
Real.
skate gods.
All right, I got this one for you guys. Tell me if you agree with this thought. So I believe there's like two types of dudes out there, right? One who carries their wallet and their keys in their hand and then sets it down when they get somewhere. And then somebody who's always got it like either in their pocket at all times. I know many people.
I'm a third type.
I was going to say, I don't know what? Anybody
really?
That yeah. walks around with a wallet in
I,
their hand.
Oh, they're like a generation above us. Like Gen X, there's a lot of them that do that. There's a dude at work, my buddy Mike. He always has them in his hand, never in his pocket. And he always sets them down.
You know why?
Why?
It's a back thing.
I'm a third one. Yeah.
Older people, it'll mess with your back. So I've heard from every old person I've ever talked to, don't put your wallet in your back pocket.
That's why I got the cargo pants.
I guarantee that's why they're holding them. It's because they get back problems.
I don't sit on it. I put it in my back pocket, but when I go to sit down, I'm like, all right, I got to put this down because it's going to...
That's fair.
Yeah. I'm with you. That's, again, most...
You just got stacks in your wallet, obviously.
I pretty much all of my pants have a cargo pocket because that's how I roll. And wallet always goes left cargo pocket.
I'm just not a cargo guy. I used to be.
Love them. That's why the Duluth pants, man.
Well,
Duluth always has that.
I really realized this literally last week that my style is not skinny jeans, but, you know, well-fitting jeans and the biggest hoodie you can buy. That's what I like. I like loose hoodies and tight jeans. I don't know why, but they're all stretch.
Loose hoodies and tight jeans.
They're all stretch.
The Adam McElroy story.
They're all stretch jeans, though. You know, it's not.
I love the stretch jeans, man.
Yeah, love
I love the stretch jeans.
Anyway.
I got another one.
If we're talking about fashion real quick, shout out Brass House.
Shout out,
there's only
dude.
A couple of hoodies left. They just posted it today.
And, sizes.
I think there's five of these hoodies left as of, 6 hours ago. So I don't even know if they have any. You can get
them
online.
I might have to do that.
I'm assuming it's brasshouseboardroom.com. I go to their Instagram. Their website's there. You can order
they're
directly off the website. They do ship it as well. But go down to the shop. Go see what they got. It's awesome.
Nice.
They have this and a camo one, by the way. So check
it
out.
Camo one doesn't have the graphic on the back, and it's cheaper.
I got the back.
It's right there. We can see it.
Tiger.
Sweet.
Tiger. Tiger.
Tiger. That tiger went tiger.
Yeah. So, yeah, I don't
know.
That was my random.
Probably not.
I don't know.
Is it tiger?
That tiger went tiger. I think it's Chris Rock.
Oh.
When he's talking about how... Everybody's like surprised that what are those like magician dudes? Not magician, but
You're talking about the
illusionist
Siegfried and Roy.
Yeah, he was because this you know it's Chris Rock, so it was a little back in the day.
Oh yeah,
and he's everybody was so upset about the tiger, and they're like the tiger went crazy. He didn't go crazy.
The tiger was just being a tiger.
He said the tiger went tiger.
Yeah,
like,
I remember that.
Yeah,
that was on Bigger and Blacker.
Now I was doing Liam Neeson in Batman Begins. Tiger.
Lion face. Ah, lemon face. Ooh. Okay, I guess that's enough thoughts. Sorry. You can shut that down, Tim. I'm sorry. I got more, but I'll save them for another day because I have a really funny one after that. But anyway.
We should probably go back to the top of where we were.
I guess
we
should talk some SLS, shouldn't we?
SLS.
SLS. Can you bring up that stuff?
Did we get a list, Tim?
Did you get us a list that we can look at?
Patrons crossed off. Skate thoughts crossed off. I think that's it.
Well, if we did that,
kind of hard to read up on that screen. I don't know.
It's all right. It'll be fine. We'll read them.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So we're looking at who's going to be in Paris.
Now,
this could all change.
Same format
as last year, I think. Same as last year, I think.
Okay.
So, I hope it's same as last year. I thought last year's was a freaking awesome format.
Yeah.
Loved that format.
Pretty cool. And it would make sense with how they're lined up if that's the case. Well, I guess not because Chloe wouldn't be with Nyjah, but still. Maybe it's vertical.
There she is. There's Momiji. I was so
that's what
the girls,
I bet it is. I bet it's vertical.
I think everybody's starting to take over Raisa or Aissa or however you say her name.
Aissa.
The Brazilian. That's weird.
Well, ours are
go back and watch. I watched a compilation of how they say her name and it changes.
Well,
every
year. You can't trust announcers. So a little lesson on Portuguese. If it starts with an R, it's an H sound. But if it's if it's a double R, then you roll it. So so that would be like an H, so it's like Haisa.
Okay,
but
it's Aissa.
Yeah, it's Aissa.
I'm ready for Skeet Oldenbuven.
You're too much. So oh dude.
By the way.
What?
Whoa.
What
I didn't know AMs could compete in SLS.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
Yeah, dude. No,
I thought everybody was a pro.
No.
That's why I always thought Felipe Mota was a pro this whole time.
Oh, no, no, no. I just, I thought,
and I didn't realize.
I thought I remember seeing his video where he went pro. I guess I was wrong.
No. And I didn't realize Giovanni just went pro recently, too. He was an AM when. Dude, SLS as well.
My favorite thing about how much you like kind of hate on Alex Midler and you think he's an angry dude and he's a jerk and all that stuff. There has been so many videos come out. They're like, yeah, Alex Midler is like the reason like I keep skating and all this stuff. There's tons of that stuff.
Look, I'm not going to. I was going to say something. I won't say something, but you can be a jerk and helpful at the same time.
We can't find any video evidence of what you say.
There was
none.
I just know there was one part of him freaking out, and I was like, dude, I don't like this guy.
But how do you like David Gravett so much? His whole thing is freaking out. Because
he's funny. He freaks out to be funny.
It's okay to be funny. It's good. It's okay.
Well, he's freaking out, but he's being funny at the same time. The video I saw of Alex was him just being a baby.
Nah.
And I was like, I don't like this guy.
This video that nobody can find.
I know, I can't find it. It was years ago.
Nobody
can find it. It was years ago. I'll be honest.
I can't find it. Anyway, so we got, I don't know, who's heavy favorite? You want? Like, it hasn't started. Who are you calling? Who's going big this year? Who's going to win it all? I think for the women.
For this event or the whole thing?
Whole thing. I want to cold call it from here.
This is my long shot. I don't think it's going to happen, but I would love for it to happen. I don't know. If I had to pick one, my long shot, let's do a long shot and then a real one.
All right.
So my long shot, it's not as long of a shot as you would think, but DeCenzo. I would love DeCenzo.
Yeah, I'm with you on that.
The other one who I think isn't a long shot, not necessarily the favorite, but possible, Vincent Malou.
Yeah.
Those are my two.
He's always up there.
Those are my two. DeCenzo. And you know what else I'm noticing about this list?
What?
No Shane O'Neill.
Yeah.
No Shane O'Neill.
He finally broke your heart and he got out.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Shane, if you watched what I said about you. I love you.
He didn't want any of the smoke.
We still love you.
I just can't.
We gave you the line of the year.
Yeah, I just can't watch you know, with judges around, dude. I'm sorry.
My long shot this year is Sora. Sora's going to take
it. Sora's a beast.
I think if I have to just call it out and I could only pick one, I want Sora to make. Because have you been seeing the work he's been putting in?
Yeah.
That guy stands on business. Yeah. He's out there, what is it? Bigger flip, sugar canes down 12 sets.
I figured you were going to say Braden.
I want Braden to do it. Yeah. There's so many people there I want to do well. You know, long shot, I want Dominic Walker to win just because the way he celebrates is the greatest thing I've ever seen.
Literally every every male on the list, I just haven't looked at the female list that closely yet. Every male on the list, I'd be stoked if they won. So,
I was going to say, you don't want Deshaun Jordan to win?
Except maybe Alex.
I love Deshaun, dude.
Deshaun Rorden?
Deshaun Rorden.
You don't want the Tigers?
He
messaged me back, dude. He's like, what?
That was cool.
I woke up to that, and I freaked out. I'm like, ooh.
Yeah. Well, because I honestly kind of hate when people post like, oh, I got a response from whatever. But it was a story I made, and it's not like I DM'd him trying to talk to him. He just saw it. And then I was like, okay, like, don't freak out. And I was like, what do I put here? And that's why I just put, life is cool sometimes. Yeah. I was like, that's a good caption. Like, but
well, it's pretty
but
pretty
in
low-key.
My bed, I'm like, oh, my God.
You know, it's the other thing is, like, Felipe Mota does have – he has the skills.
Facts.
He has
very
the
good.
Skills to
He's
win
Jay
this.
Kickflip blunt.
Yeah.
Hollywood 16.
Yeah.
Jeez.
He has the skills to really, like – To at least win a stop. And I don't know what it is that he hasn't been able to break. But, I mean, he's also...
He's 17, by the way.
I know.
He'll be 18 in April. I looked it up.
He is a kid.
But,
So, yeah, for the women, I don't know if Chloe's going to be able to stay on top. I think Momiji's, like, she's amazing. Yumika Iota, she's amazing as well. Yeah, but they're all the women skaters are pretty, like, they're all very young.
Yeah.
I think the oldest I think is like maybe like 21. They're all really good. I've gotten to the point that
18 or 19.
Like, I think she was like I thought she was like 16.
Oh, okay.
Cuz I think last year she was 15.
Oh, well.
She's super tall though. She's
right,
like
that's
6'1".
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. She's like taller than most of the dudes standing there. Wow. It's crazy. But they're all really good, and it's and they're really stepping up their game. So yeah, I don't. I really like the way Momiji skates. I think the reign of Aisa is over. They're all getting too good. Yeah. But yeah, so I'm excited for SLS.
I am too. That's this Saturday.
Shout out to
Crappy
Rumble.
Do we know what time it is?
Who knows? It's Paris, dude. That's the problem. Yeah. I'm just going to catch it when I catch it. And I'm going to watch it in line and go back through and watch it.
Go to the SLS page, Tim. You can just click on their...
Rudol,
click on their name. Duh. Yeah. Because it'll show you, like, Paris time, and then
like
we'll
this
just...
This time, and here's Northwest, whatever.
So...
Who are you?
Doesn't say.
Does it...
Largest prize person.
Do you see the
1.8 million?
What?
The circles right below that? No. Yep. Down. The actual, yeah. Hit the arrow on the right. Is there a Paris one?
No.
Or these are older.
Those are older.
So scroll down then a little bit.
I don't see it.
Do that top right one. That black
one.
Yeah,
let's try that.
Oh,
you can scroll through this. You can no. You gotta hit the little arrow.
Left.
We'll teach
right.
you.
Nope. Left, right.
Next
right.
to the three bubbles there. There you go.
Okay,
here it is.
So
doesn't say.
SLS Apex, huh? Interesting. How at 1.8 million?
It's combined.
That's crazy.
1.8 combined.
Australia
okay,
too.
Nothing there.
Nope.
I don't know.
So they're doing Super Crown in Sao Paulo again. Knock it off, man. Keep that in the States. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
It doesn't matter. Anyway, so yeah, that's SLS. That's coming up this weekend. We're excited about it. If we figure out times, I don't know. This isn't coming out in time anyways. Go back up. I want to see the course again. Scroll back up. Look at that course. I want to skate that course so bad.
The course is awesome.
Dang, that looks good. I have a feeling that Jocelyn is going to send from there all the way over and do something on that rail.
What?
He's going to go from one side of the park to the other.
Nah.
That is my... Look at that big rail. There's a Kelvin Hoffer special is going to happen on that rail.
No, that's a Jamie Foy special. What are you talking about?
Kelvin Hoffler, dude. He's the one that does the back... The back nose to
on hubbas,
front table.
He doesn't do that on rails.
Front
he does
tail.
It on hubbas.
So?
Yeah, so on a rail, that's a Jamie Foy special.
Your phone is going to blow up when he does it on that rail.
I would love him to do it on the rail, but I've only ever seen him do it on a hubba.
Yeah. I love that.
Oh, there's the lineup.
No, there's the stupid thing.
There it was.
So stupid website.
Scroll down a little bit. What were those three in the middle? Down.
Look at her. Cool. Where's the blah,
general
blah, blah.
Admission. Just click on general admission.
I'll do it.
I wonder if it's going to give us a time.
France.
Oh.
Et la France.
Nope.
Yeah.
Nope. 35 euros? Man.
Yeah. No.
Let me
All
in.
Right.
Interesting.
All right. Whatever.
Okay.
Is Aurelien French?
Aurelien is French, yes. He's
oh,
from
cool.
Paris.
Good for him. He's not in this one.
He's not?
I didn't see him on there.
Yeah, he is. It. He is.
What?
He was cruising around with everybody.
Whatever. All right, fine.
Still stop it.
Stop it. So we did that. What's next?
Probably
Winter Sessions. Yeah, we talk about Winter Sessions now. So Winter Sessions started last Friday.
Swag.
Next one starts tomorrow. We got big obstacles this time.
Yeah. And no matter when
freaking
you see
Cam
this,
just sending it off of everything.
Yeah. No matter when you see this, there's going to be a Winter Session this Friday. So come out.
Yep. Don't forget that on the 5th is when our event's happening.
Yes.
And we've got sponsors for everything.
I'm excited.
Which is pretty crazy. We
yeah,
got
let's
Stoke Run.
Yep.
We got Backbone Moxie.
Yep.
We got Mickey D's.
Yep. Monica.
Good old Donnie's.
Organization. Yep.
Monica's organization. You got it. Got to go there. We got, did I say Stoke Run? Stoke Run.
You already did say Stoke Run.
Yeah.
We got Stoke Run twice.
Okay. We really
There's two more that
really
you're forgetting.
Have.
Third Life Upcycling.
Yep. And there's one more that they're going to be upset if you forget. They're literally on the
Brass
screen.
House?
Yeah, they're on
say,
the screen,
isn't it,
bro.
Isn't it Brass House?
I was trying
Honestly,
to
I do want to say, too, like, shout out to Brennan and Libby at Brass House, just because, yeah, like,
that's been fun.
One of the big things too for the winter sessions was having enough helmets for everybody.
Oh, dude, they
came, and they came in so clutch because they were like, "What do you need?" And it's like, literally all we need is helmets.
Yes.
So they
and they gave us pads. Well, they gave us pads at a super discount.
Yeah.
So we got some pads too if
so
people want them or need them.
So yeah, we have plenty of helmets and pads for
if anybody
really
wants to
the
come
future.
Out and try.
Yeah. Yeah.
We got pads and helmets for you and boards.
There is a waiver if you.
Oh,
want.
Advocate Skateworks. That's the
Advocate
other one.
Skateworks. Yep, definitely.
That's the other one. Sorry.
But there is a waiver for the winter sessions. Again, just a reminder: if you're under 18, you do have to wear a helmet. We had to remind a couple people last week.
Micah.
That's okay. Steven, who's 5 and didn't know any better.
Yeah.
He didn't have a helmet on at one point, and I was like, Rocky,
grounded.
And I did this, and.
Yep.
And Rocky
I kept
was,
yelling at kids, and I'm like,
"Oh, I know."
I did that, and Rocky's like, "Oh, he's fine." And I was like,
"I know you're talking
and he's
about
like,
now."
I don't care.
He's like, "Oh, are they required?" And I'm like, "You know they're required, dude. Get him a helmet." Like,
nice kid.
If you're under 18, they're required.
Cracks me up.
But we
Rocky
had a good turnout. I think the official number was 26 people, which I thought there
I've
was
been telling
more
people
that.
Almost 30. That's 26, right?
Yeah. But yeah, I'm gonna actually 30. get you a list. To print off to give your mom.
Oh, okay.
So that when people walk in, she can just kind of check them off the list.
That's easier than trying to find it all.
Yeah, and then that way, if they're not on the list, come find me. And
that's
we'll
great.
Do the or scan the waiver or whatever.
Yeah.
And she asked if I wanted her to keep the waiver thing.
Yeah.
And I said, well, if you keep them, that means you have to come back next week. She was like, I'm coming back anyway. I'm like, but still. Like,
so, the thing is like my mom and my sister, they live up north. They live in Huron and Vermilion up in that area.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's where they live. So my niece, my youngest niece, she's 10. She wanted to start, like, wants to skate. It's all she thinks about. So she's trying it. Mm-hmm. She's having fun. Shout outs to Brass House Broward Room. And shout outs Brennan specifically. Yep. He helped her drop in on the half pipe there.
Really?
It was awesome.
Wow.
She was so stoked. It was great.
Yeah. Won't even
and,
try that.
And she won one of the boards in the drawing. She won the DX board.
Wow.
It was awesome cuz we were in line. She was buying a Thrasher hat. She's like, "I got to have the Thrasher hat." I'm like,
"That's awesome.
Get it. It's dope."
That's awesome.
And she's like buying it and they're like, "Iris." And
right.
And we're like, "Ah," I'm like, "You won."
Yeah.
Ah! So yeah, it was really cool.
Yeah, and I want to say too, you know, we made a post about it, you know, that night and stuff, but I do just want to reiterate, like, this is such a cool community because I saw specifically it was with Iris that somebody was helping her, like, mm-hmm. who literally just met her 2 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Like, they don't know each other, but they saw it and, like, was helping her over the ramps and stuff, and I'm like, this is just such a cool
yep.
environment. Like, it's not like, you know,
so
there
good.
Was no shade at all. Like,
no.
There was kind of, you know, me and the other people over in the corner trying to get, you know, either first-time skaters or trying to get, like, our wheels under us, you know, to get a feel for it. And then there's people over here doing tray flips and, you know, ollieing over Deshaun Rorden.
Yeah.
And, like, all this kind of stuff. And there's just such a mix of every skill level. And at the same time, everybody just meshes so well at the same time. So, like, it's just so cool to see.
Had a real dope time of, like, kind of like a fellowship and a way to come around everybody at the end. We sit and chat a
when
little bit.
When you say loving on everybody, a couple people looked at me like, huh? You kept saying, like, if anybody needs loved on, and they were like, huh?
Well,
but I knew what you meant. But
yeah, man.
And they knew what you meant, too.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
they
yeah.
were like,
but
that's
it's
a
just,
weird way to word it.
It's
just terminology,
really,
you know?
Yeah. It's just really cool at the end to be able to, like, kind of fellowship and just kind of take a second and be real with each other.
Right.
And just kind of chat and pray for each other and all that stuff when that happened. Because there was some stuff that went on, and it was nice to be able to, just as a group, just kind of, like, you know, pray for them and be, you know, with them for that. And on that note, I just want to shout out Crossroads for letting us do
Facts.
This. It's so bonkers. And I just want to put it out there. If nobody has anywhere to go for Easter, come over to Crossroads, dude. They let us skate. It's so awesome there. And I got to be in the planning committee for what we're doing for Easter this year. It sounds awesome. Mostly, like, I tell them, like, I have to be in there because when you come to me and say, hey, can you build this? I'm like, I need to be able to tell you at the beginning whether it's possible
it's
or not.
Plausible.
They've come to me with stuff, and I'm like, that can't be done.
Right.
Or it's like,
You need a real professional. Well, I always do something like that.
I always tell them, like, anything can be done with the right budget.
Right.
How much money you got for this? Right. Because I'm like, it's going to take a lot to do. So it was nice this time to kind of see like where their head was with what they're doing and all that stuff. But yeah, Crossroads, normal services will be, you know, our Saturday night at 7, Sunday at 9 and 11, 10 a.m. at the Ontario. And they have a one in Shelby, 10 a.m. at Shelby. But anyway, come to Crossroads for Easter. It's dope. It's so much fun. And I'm so blown away that like a place that I work at's like, hey, man, what you're doing is dope. How can we help?
Yeah,
That's crazy to me. So it's really awesome that they do that. So shout out to our sponsors. Shout out to Crossroads for letting us do this. And yeah, so that's winter sessions and stuff. But yeah, that's kind of the big updates we had for this episode and what's going on. We'll try to keep you updated with the stuff to come because there's definitely more coming with Lexington.
Mm-hmm.
I might just go kick open some doors and be like, hey, give me money. Yeah, I want to fix this park.
The goal is to have this skatable by the summer. So, or within the summer anyway.
Yes.
Like, might not be at the beginning of the summer.
I mean, Sam told me, he's like, this is really just a 2-day project. We can make this happen.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that made this so much better.
Right.
That's a 2-day project. I mean, because we'll need one day to remove the obstacles because we'll have to take them out of the ground. I know there's going to be some stuff that needs fixed, but we have... Through the church and stuff, we have welders and everybody who can help us with that stuff. But, I mean, we have the okay. That is the number one thing we needed. We needed the okay to be able to do this. It was kind of the same way with Liberty. They needed the okay to do what they wanted to do, and they got it now, which is awesome.
And I'm really excited to your point earlier, too, about how Lexington might be willing to throw in a little bit of money as well.
That's really cool. Yeah.
Because I just know for a fact... Once this gets done, there will be dozens of people there every day.
That's what we were trying to tell people too. It's like you know, like oh, we said it while we were there. It's like this is going to be a crowded skate park.
Yeah, and like, and it's cool because when it happens, like we're just and not to bring it in this aspect, but like we're just gonna be proven right.
Yeah,
you know, and they're gonna be able to see that.
Oh yeah,
there are people here every day.
Yep,
and all it took was concrete, and it's been sitting there.
Years.
8 to 10 years without being used, basically. You know what I mean? Like, they were about to rip it out, and it's like, bro, just give it a little bit of love, a little bit of updates, and we're good to go. So I'm really excited.
I am too. I guess, tease it for next time, I guess. But I get to go talk to Shelby as well.
Yeah.
I got in with city councilman. And I got to sit down, chat with him, and I said, here's what I'm proposing for Shelby. Here's what I'm thinking. Right. And he took that back, talked to city council, and he's like, yep, they want to talk to you. You got to come in and sell them on this. And I'm like, I can do that.
Yeah.
You open that door, I'm walking through, and I'm going to make it happen. So before, that's next.
Before we end, too, just real quick, just a shout out to Stoke Run, because by the time you guys see this, there is going to be the Shred Like a Girl event.
Ooh, exciting.
Here on the
2nd.
We're going
to be there. We're going to have snow cones.
Yeah.
Just saying.
March 2nd, cones. I believe it's 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
No, I'm not there. I'll
and 10 to 12 is like a free skate
working
type
Saturday?
Thing.
No, I'm going out of town for my birthday.
Shout out to Tim's birthday. Wait, your birthday isn't until...
The 4th.
The 4th. That's right, because yours is the 4th. My sister's is... The 8th, my mom's is the 7th. Everybody's got a freaking birthday. Jim's is in May.
You know what I want to do for my birthday in December?
What you doing?
Get everybody to go to Shred Like a Girl at Stoke Run on March 2nd, 10 to 4. I think 10 to 12 is like a free skate time.
Oh, and he's going to have. It's not just skateboarding. It is.
It's everything.
Roller skating and rollerblading as well. That's one part of it. I was talking to Travis this morning, and I'm emceeing and DJing the skate part of it. But there's also plenty of trainers and stuff there for people who are first time. So I'm excited for that for my niece.
Yeah.
There's going to be people who are solely dedicated to like teaching them a lot of stuff and running them through a program.
And let
so
me
that's
see
awesome.
Too, because there was, I don't know if you saw, I don't know if it was in the post or not.
Snow cones.
But yeah, I'm not. Let me see.
We're going to have cherry and blue raspberry.
They're doing different awards as well. I'm trying to see if I can find it. I'm not gonna be able to pull it up.
Roodle doodle do.
But they're doing a lot of different awards. Like even like one of them was like most improved for the day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like that, so.
I'm excited for that too. It's just gonna be cool to see. That's the stuff I love, man.
Yeah.
It just warms my heart.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
I'm gonna drink some more of this.
So prizes: most improved, Little Shredders, best trick, worst slam, best run, most hype, and never gave up. So those are all the awards that you can get.
At Winter Sessions, Justin wore the worst slam shirt that he won last year.
Yeah. Nice. And he brought out the inline.
Shouts. Oh, dude, he is so good.
Yeah, it was an interesting.
He went over to Sean Rorden. He did, I can't remember the name of it. So a cross up, 180, and he wanted to do a 540. I'm like, don't hurt yourself.
Yeah, put a helmet on, please.
But he's so good though. I love.
Yeah,
so Doug said he was going to bring his inline skates this week.
Yeah, but get out to Stoke on Saturday, March 2nd. Come see your boys.
Come see us. And we're going to have temporary tattoos. We're going to give you tattoos. We're going to give you snow cones. What more do you want?
Why not real tattoos, you know?
Maybe we'll do that. I'm not. No tattoos on this body, baby. Ain't happy. Tim, do you have a tattoo?
Body's a temple. No.
It is a temple.
I do not.
Okay. See? We don't have tattoos.
Well.
I'm going to sneeze. Like, we better end this.
I know. I'm in the same way. So we appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Please like, subscribe. We're on Twitch right now, but don't forget, go over to the YouTube, and subscribe over there and all that kind of stuff. That's where the full episode.
Maybe we'll get Streamlabs Ultra so we can stream on Twitch and YouTube.
Yeah, I mean, that's a thought, but we appreciate you guys, and there's one thing left to do, bro.
Go skate.